Case Study, Listening to Looks at Books, Narcissistic Personality Disorder.
Hello and welcome to Listening to Looks at Books, the show where we look at books, we listen to each other, report back on what we looked at. I'm your host, Robert We have a wonderful panel today. Some old favorites and some new people we don't know yet who have yet to be judged in the baptism of the show.
That seems much more intense than I would.
First up.
I wasn't told it would be.
We have our returning favorite. She's just back from the hospital where she was taking a brief vacation. Countess Renata. Countess, good to have you back.
Hi, it's so good to be back, Robert.
I understand you read a book.
I did.
That's part of the show.
Well, I was in...
Tell me the book you've read about.
It's called In Hospice, and it's... I just come out just today, because I've got probably another week there. And, you know...
You think you'd talk faster. Well... Moving down the line, it's good to see this gentleman back. We haven't seen him since he tried to jump Snake River Canyon.
I may be 94 years old, but I still may have it if I make it.
That's right. Here's Roger Nickelfather. Roger, what book did you read? And please tell me about the book.
I read the sequel to The Great Expectations called Just Okay Expectations, and... frankly, my expectations were low, so it was pretty good.
Did it have a front and a back?
No, it only had the one, the middle.
Sounds like a mystery is brewing.
Would you cut me off now?
Next we have... a gentleman who is here every single week. God, what's his name? It's, you think? I see the guy every single week.
I can tell you my name.
No, let me get it. Edgerton Myroncock. Am I close?
It's Hans. I read a book called The Leviathan Bitch. And it's a very good book. I liked it.
What's it about and why?
It's about an underwater lady who is very mean to everyone. It's pretty self-explanatory. I can't believe it, I made it this far. But normally you may go on to the next guy.
Give me a little more.
The lady...
And look who's here. For the first time, we have a self-proclaimed functional illiterate on the show. We're going to see what he thought was a book and if he is correct. Please welcome Mitch Happenstance.
Hi. I'm happy to be here. And while I am functionally illiterate, I'm blessed with a beautiful wife who likes to read aloud to me before we go to bed each night.
Book time. What was it?
The last book she read me was The 400 Steps. And basically, a young couple begins climbing a staircase.
To the chase.
They age along the way.
How does it end?
They die. They reach the summit.
Now we have this little lady. What a pleasure to see her. She's just finished a run of reading books on Broadway. It's called Audiobook The Experience. Please welcome Dame Judy Dench. Hold on. Not the famous one.
Did very poorly. I don't know why.
Now, you recently had some nodes implanted in your throat.
Yeah, it's been a rough couple of years.
Dame Jude, what was your favorite book that you ever yelled at people?
It was called Aliens. Are They Among Us? Yes.
It's all right there in the cover.
There was more under the cover!
We're going to go... Oh, spicy. We're going to go down the line. Everyone has to tell me a book that they haven't read yet, but they would like to read, which also has not been written and doesn't exist. So, Countess.
Yes, Deathbed Erotica. And I'm quite excited.
Ron.
Just okay, Gatsby.
Hands.
I'd like to write a book about swimming.
The Dum Dum.
That's my loaf.
Your Excellency.
That's my loaf as well! We share loaves!
Uh-oh. We're out of time because I'm getting sleepy. Thank you all for being here for another successful edition of Listening to Look at Books. Join us again next week when everything is exactly the same. I'm your host, Robert... Oh...